It's your boy Jimmy Blue, Mr. All Access Elite Boxing, reporting live from Grand Prairie, Texas. I'm here with the father of Vergil Ortiz. Vergil Ortiz Sr., how you doing, Vergil?
Pretty good. How you doing, Jim?
I'm doing good, man. Thank you. Thank y'all for coming out, man. This is your third meet and greet, man, you and your son, within the last 24, 40 hours here in the Dallas Grand Prairie Fort Worth Metroplex, man. How does it feel to have the fans come out and support your son?
It feels pretty good. He's out here. A little chilly out here, but he's out here for the fans and for the people to, get to meet him. He's hardly ever home. He's always training. So this gives everybody a good opportunity to finally, come out here and get to see him in case they don't get to see him at his fight.
I was telling you, I spoke with your son earlier, man. I was mentioning to him that, last Friday, brother, he got the knockout. It was against a tough, rugged opponent, and I felt that he learned something from that fight, considering that he fought a different style fighter, man. What was the game plan going into that fight?
Really, the game plan was just more of him being patient still. Just break the guy down little by little. In case the guy is kind of tricky. Because, the guy's tricky. He has a real slick style. I know they say that he hadn't fought in a year or something, but people don't know that he's actually been ready to fight, except his fights have been falling through. So he's actually been in shape. And so it was more just, be ready, because the guy's real slick, so just stay composed and try to break him down little by little.
At what point throughout the fight did you know that your son was going to knock him out?
Before the fight. Before the fight. And it's not to be cocky or nothing, but I know what my son is. I know what I have. I've already knew by looking how my son was sparring. There's times in the gym when the guy is training and sparring that you can still see where he might get stuck a bit, as in trying to get over the hump, as in like timing wise. But once they get there, then everything starts falling in place, and you can just see his. You can see him think, actually starting to dissect guys, thinking, and all the athleticism all kicking in at once. So I knew it. I could see it in the future.
He's only 21 years old, brother. He's 15-0, 15 knockouts, 100% knockout ratio. 2019 has been a hell of a year for Team Ortiz, man. It couldn't have gotten any better, I feel. Three knockouts against three tough opponents. How important is it for you, man, as a father and, as his trainer, to keep that momentum going, getting even bigger fights in 2020?
How is it what? I'm sorry, because I couldn't hear real quick.
I said, how is it important for you to continue the momentum for 2020?
Well, it's important for him, and it's important for every fighter, really. For them to keep the momentum going, because it keeps them in rhythm. It keeps them in timing. You don't want to stay too inactive, because your body heals at the same time, but at the same time your body gets rusty. So it's important just in overall, so that way once you're cruising and you're going, and just kind of like, okay, now you can just go through, not just going through the stuff. So it's everything's always important.
What would you say, Vergil? I mean, you've been obviously in your son's corner since his whole amateur career, his whole professional career. What has been the most satisfying victory up to date for you?
Pro-wise would be Mauricio Herrera. And that's only because he was talking a lot of shit. And usually, we try not to talk shit. We try not to, we try to respect the other guy, because that's how I would like for them to be with my son. But he just kept saying that when someone was a little boy, and that the only way Vergil wins was that when they robbed him, that they were gonna rob. That he was saying that he already knew he was gonna lose, because he was gonna get robbed, but that he was gonna put a schooling and a beating on my son. Because I seen the interview, and that's kind of for me. I was already more motivated for my son. I knew my son was gonna take him out, and I actually I thought he was gonna take him out in the sixth round. So he got him out there a lot earlier than I expected.
Did he say anything to you guys after the fight?
No, he didn't tell us anything. I think he even put in a video something about he only had 2 months to work out, to train, and he didn't take it so, I don't want to say serious, but at the same time, my son only had 2 months to worry too, because they were both notified at the same time. That was the first time fighting at 147. And actually, they wanted it at 147. Vergil was still 140. We still were going to do 140. So they moved Vergil up, and I don't think they realize how much power Vergil has. And when they move it up to 147, that's going to be his first time where he didn't really have to kill himself to make that weight. But he's going to be way stronger than they anticipated. And you get what you asked for.
You know, man, when I